Maybe God is the one in control. Regardless of what we face in life, we always remember that God is still in control. And I don't know what's going to happen in D.C. in November 2024, but what I do know is that God is still in control. I don't know about all the lies that were said last week at the Republican convention, but I know God is still in control. I don't know all the lies they're going to tell next month in the Democratic convention, but the Lord is still in control. And look what he said. He said, y'all meant it for evil, but the Lord meant it for good. And I got to leave you here now, but somebody ought to have a book that can testify about that the enemy meant it for good, for evil, but the Lord, he turned it around for your good. I got to get out of here, y'all, but Judas meant it for evil when he betrayed Jesus, but Jesus knew it would be for good. The soldiers that speared him in the side meant it for evil, but Jesus knew it would be for good. The thorn they put on his head were meant for evil, but later on it would be turned into good. They put him in a borrowed tomb meant it for evil, but the Lord 3 days later turned it to good. And there ought to be somebody in the house that can testify they meant it for my evil, but the Lord, he turned it for my good. Just find your one neighbor and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, hang on in there. God's getting ready to turn this situation. There ought to be somebody that I know he'll turn it around. When your enemy mentions for evil, God turns it around for your good. Anybody in here say, I was sick, but God, he healed my wife. I was hurt, but God, he mended my broken heart. Won't the Lord do it? Won't the Lord do it? Yes, he will. Find one more neighbor and say, neighbor, this is the last time I'm around with you. But I gotta tell you, let it go, let it go, let it go. Have love, have peace in your heart. Forgive those that don't ask for forgiveness. And the Lord will bless you. The Lord will keep you. The Lord will protect you. The Lord will hold you. They won't even lose you. But God gave you a peace of mind. They thought you were over the power, but you kept on fighting. You kept on going. You kept on going. Is there anybody that can testify? I survived betrayal. They betrayed me. They tried to kill me. They tried to take me out. But I'm still here. I'm still here. And I still got joy and love down in my heart. In the house today that can testify like me. They said I was the mountain. They said I wouldn't be here today. They said I wasn't from good stock. But the Lord had a plan for my life. And won't he do it? I feel you release it back. That betrayal has had a forgiveness in your heart. Won't the Lord forgive you? I gotta get out of here, y'all. But I just dare to look past all the betrayal and say, but the Lord still made a way. But the Lord still put food on my table. But the Lord still gave me that promotion. But the Lord still gave me that car. But the Lord still gave me the new job. But the Lord, he told me about it. But the Lord paid that last bill. But the Lord made a way out of nowhere. the Lord keeps on keeping. But the Lord heals my sick body. Won't he do it? Just look at a neighbor and say, neighbor, I know what he can do. Many can't sleep at night because they have not forgiven. But it's hurting nobody but you. It's killing nobody on the inside but you. And I know it hurts. I know it's hard. But you can survive betrayal if you're willing to have forgiveness over bitterness. You can survive betrayal if you see God's sovereign hand on your life. You can survive betrayal if you realize that your pain had a purpose. Because God knew what he was getting ready to do in your life. You just got to be willing to forgive. And the Lord will continue to forgive you. Listen. Maybe there's someone in the house today that falls in one of these three categories. You've never accepted the first category, never been baptized, never done the sinner's prayer. If that's you this morning, you want to come. We don't put chairs out anymore. We take you in the back and have a private conversation. You don't know where you're going to spend eternity. You don't know if you left here and died right now where you would spend eternity. If you're here in the sanctuary, you want to come right now and walk down the aisle now. Maybe the second, you're the second category. You've accepted, but you've been baptized, but you need a church home. You know, a place where you can grow spiritually, where you can be discipled. That'll teach you that you can battle back from betrayal. That's you, you don't have a church home, you don't have a covering. If you want to come, if you're in the house, come down the aisle now. The invitation is extended. Will you come? Thirdly, maybe you're from work, military, college. You don't want to move your membership, but you want to come while you're here. If that's you, today's your day. You want to come. You want to come. You want to come. Maybe you're in Peace Station. You're watching virtually. No worries. This is a global ministry. All you have to do is text connect GPBC to 84576. Our ambassador Christ are waiting to receive you virtually. In person, in the house, virtual. If you're there in one of those three categories, come now. Come now. The door is open, the invitation is extended. Will you come? Will you come? Virtually, will you come? Text connect, keep it easy. One word. We extend now the invitation to the altar, for altar call, our corporate altar call prayer. Don't always be like this. You will always be in the pit. You will always be in the prison. The palace is available for you. This time. If you turn around. total control. That I came and I picked moments, each had a purpose to get us in the palace. Somebody who's here right now is just trying to muster it up to forgive somebody. Help us all to go from forgiving for unforgiveness and get out of our bitterness. God, forgive us of our own trespasses and sin. Cleanse our hearts from our wrongdoing. God, right now in the name of Jesus, I just ask that you touch these, your people, with what it is they're standing in the need of. Touch those that are watching virtually. Touch those in the house. God, now put the butt in their life that the world's ministry needs. But God, we believe you're getting ready to turn this thing around for good. So God, get ready to turn the lives of your people around. God, that turn their situation around. God, where they can testify in with nobody but you. God, somebody's sick right now. Somebody's in the hospital bed right now. Somebody's on their bed of affliction right now. Heal them, God. Some are dealing with emotional wounds. Heal them, God. Some need you to deliver them. Deliver them, God. Open up, God, the floodgates of heaven. And allow your healing, allow your blessings, allow your peace, allow your joy to flow down on these, your people. Keep us now. Strengthen us like only you can do. God, touch our leading lady this morning. Continue to strengthen her to give her yet full recovery. Be with Brother Brunson this morning to give healing, God, and recovery. Be with all of those that are sick that we may not even know about to give healing, God, and recovery. God, we're asking for restoration right now. Physical restoration, mental restoration, emotional restoration, family restoration. God, restore now. Come what you can do. Lord, if you decide not to do these things, do something even better, something even greater. In your Son, Jesus, name we pray. And all of God's children agreed by saying amen, amen, amen. Encourage somebody next to you. Tell God, get ready to pray for you. Don't forget to give donations. It's just a walk. It's just over here.